I'm Brendan, and I'm a storyteller. I seek out the world's best adventures and anecdotes. And I'll go to any corner of the globe to find them. And boy, do I have a story for you. It seems like in Tokyo, there's always some place to go and something to do. The city is alive with experiences and opportunities to engage every one of your five senses at any given time. No matter your age or nationality or place in Japanese society, Tokyo is ready for you. In Harajuku, Tokyo's young people have created a subculture all their own with bright and bold fashions, hobbies, and myriad things to entertain themselves.
In the Harajuku district of Tokyo, you never know what you're going to see. Whether it's the bustling youth culture or crazy fashion trends, this neighborhood is hopping.
Youth culture in Tokyo has embraced the world around them, but also sort of an apocalyptic fantasy world as well. That might mean an overnight stay in a comic book store, where sleeping in cubicles can be rented for as little as a buck an hour. This homeless comic artist became kind of a local celebrity when she took up residence in a local shop. Others make a career by showing off their personal style and selling their wares online. This woman makes kimonos decorated with breakfast foods. Seriously. And what better way to document that fashion than by spending a Friday night inside of one of many underground arcades filled with photo booths? It's like Instagram, but with more hardware. But maybe you're looking for a more traditional side of Tokyo. The Tsukiji Fish Market is the biggest seafood market in the world, and whether you're craving fresh tuna, elegant teas, or the finest cutlery made by man, this is the spot for you. If it flies or swims or grows in the ground, you can probably buy it here, for a price. Even if what you're trying to buy isn't strictly legal everywhere in the world, here's a bear, and yep, that's a stuffed bald eagle.
The fresh seafood around this market is completely like anywhere else in the world. You buy it right out of the shell, and there's not even stopping. You just take it, eat it right here on the street, and keep moving. The best way to find marine products is to know when they're in season, and then find a way to get them as close to the ocean as possible. We're learning all over here that the months when tuna and salmon and all these different things come from the north of Japan, with all this raw seafood and everything, some people might wonder, is it safe? Is it clean? When something tastes this good, it might be worth the salmonella. Here at Sushi Zanmai, they have a reputation for liking things big and liking them fresh. Last year, they paid more than 150 million yen for the biggest tuna to come into the market last year. This fish weighed more than 100 pounds, and it was known for being the top quality. This is one of the tachi sushi restaurants, meaning standing sushi, rather than the rotating sushi which we've seen around the city. It's almost 9 a.m. and where some people think sushi is just a dinner meal, it's really perfect for any meal of the day. Itadakimasu.
You'll find world-class food all over the city, whether you're looking for the finest fish or mouth-watering Kobe beef. Dining in Japan is a social experience. At many restaurants, you'll cook your own food right at the table as a way of bonding with your dinner companions. These social conventions are a part of the ancient tapestry of Japanese culture that still exist today. In Tokyo, tradition still matters. Whether it's removing your shoes before entering a restaurant, home, or traditional hotel, or participating in a formal afternoon tea ceremony whose history dates back 1400 years, even traditional foods are a critical part of modern Japan. Cooking a rice cracker in an open-air market seems like a simple task, but it's a lot harder than it looks.
It's salty, it's rich, it's smoky. There's really nothing like this anywhere else in the world.
And when it's time to unwind at the end of the day, there's no shortage of new traditions to energize the city's nightlife. Karaoke means empty orchestra in Japanese, and it's been a favorite here since the 1970s. 40 years ago, most Japanese houses were made of wood, and singing at home was very distracting to your neighbors. In 1984, the first karaoke box was introduced in Tokyo. Private rooms where you can drink and sing with your friends without disturbing the peace. Or maybe, you'd rather just watch the show without participating. In Tokyo's red light district of Kabuki Town, they've got you covered. Reporting live from the tallest building in Tokyo. Long way from them hallways. Filled with O's and O's. Day counting, always. Real fat, all day. Now, baby, we can parlay. Oh, baby, we can party. She read books, especially about red rooms and tie-ups. I got her hooked, cause she see me in a suit with a red tie tied up. It's nice to meet you, but time is money. Only difference is I own it. Now let's stop time and enjoy this moment.